And welcome to another fly tying tutorial with Privas Fiskeflur. Today I'm going to tie this fly. This is a high float mayfly emerger. I'm going to show you how to tie this little critter and show you what materials and hook I've been using. Okay, first of all, I start with a hook. I start with this hook, Klinkhammer size 12. Extreme Klinkhammer, very nice hook indeed. And in the body I use this synthetic quills from Vanyards, and I have for an indication of the wing and the flotation of this fly a suspender ball from Vanyards. This comes in mixed sizes. One bag has abundance of this little ball, so you don't need much. This ball is packed in one of my wife's old nylon stockings. This is a size, I don't know size, but this is color tan. It's my wife's, not my own. I don't have any. Okay. For the thread, I'm using this thread. This is a not known thread for most of you. This is a Serafield thread. The thread contains of two small thread that wind together. That makes this thread very easy to split. I got this thread from a very nice fly tire and fly fisherman. A very known man in Norway. He's called Staffan Lindström. You can get this thread from a company called Silk Lady. I'm gonna try to post it on my video, the link to this place. And yes, and of course, the feather on this CDC feather on this fly is from this company, Drangedal Produkter in Norway. The best CDC I've ever used. It comes in several kinds, several colors, but I don't have all the colors yet. I have a little bag I got with mixed colors. This is all jumbo CDC feathers. The feather is, I have one loose here. I think that's two, but I have them. You see the quality of this feather. This is 6 centimeters long. Very, very nice fibers on this. Very good. Okay, for folding the feathers, I have used my own made folding tool. This is a, well, you see, it's a wooden block of oak that I have used my saw and cut out slots, several, from the thinnest on the end here, thicker and thicker and thicker, broader and broader, I mean, so I can just put the feather in this and fold it. I'm gonna show you how to do this in the tying sequence. Also use this kind of wax for the dubbing wax on the loop. This is a ski wax, well used, but you have this kind of wax all your life. You can't use up one of those. It's not so expensive either. And I use this clip to handle a CDC feather. This is an ordinary paper clip. You have to use the one like looks like this, with the straight edges, more or less the flat. And I also have this from Stonefo. This is also a clamp. This is a see-through thing, but that's not necessary. That's all I'm gonna tell you right now, and skip to the tying part. So follow on with the tying part. Well, hello again and welcome to the tying port. I start with putting a hook in the vise. I use this Partridge clink hammer. Put it onto the vise like that. Make sure it stays there. Okay, on with the glasses and attaching my thread. This is a Serafil thread, unknown to many of those out there, but this is a fly tying thread I got from a guy named Staffan Lindström. This is very easy to split. It's non-waxed, so I have to wax it. Okay, I start with putting on a layer of thread on this hook, because I'm gonna attach some synthetic quills from Vineyards. Try to make a little base of thread like that, back and forth until I get the desired result. It's not gonna be so much, but a little bit. Okay, I stop there. I take out my quill like that, take out one piece. There was two, but I have to split it, so it's one. Yes, then you have that. Okay, attach it on the side, try not to, it's very slippery this, so well. Go up, make a half hitch. A little bit slippery, so like that. Okay, now I'm gonna take the rotation on my vise just to wind this on. I find it's much easier to do that than doing hand over hand method. Try not to overlap, but they have to be tight, so it will not, the thread will not show between. Up to about there, and then you take your tying thread over and attach it like that. And then you can take your scissor and snip it off. If you want now, you can reinforce this with some UV resin, but I'm allergic to that stuff, so I don't do that. I can put on some lacquer, but for the video I don't do that now. But this is very strong, but you can reinforce it like I said with some UV resin or lacquer. Okay, now I'm gonna attach the styrofoam ball, suspender ball. I take out one. This is very magnetic stuff, so it pops up. You have the whole living room full of it. You have one in my hand, and take my old, that this is not my old stockings, sorry about that, it's my wife's. So I take it in the stocking like that, wind the thread up a little bit, make a little space at until the eye, and attach it like that, and snip off. This styrofoam ball, suspendable, will make this fly float like a dream. Okay, you can see now it's, you can take some wrappings around just to reinforce it. Now I'm gonna put on some hackle. I'm gonna use this hackle. This is a CDC feather from this company. The best CDC feather I've tested. Drangedal Produkter is a place in Drangedal in Telemark. Very good feather. This is a jumbo feather. It's about 6 centimeters long. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna show you with another camera. So stay there and we'll go on and show you. Now you see, I changed the angle. This is my homemade CDC folding tool. This is a wooden block made of oak, and I have used my saw and make a cut about 1.5 centimeters. This is a cone, larger on the top and smaller on the point. So what I'm gonna do now, I take my feather in my both hands, see what slit fits the feather best. This is appropriate, and this also is very good. So I take it and push it down, and you see it folds like that. And then I take my clip. I can use this clip now. This is a ordinary paper clip. I also have this clip. This is a Stonefor clip. It's a little small to this large feather, so I don't use that. I take the large one, take it over my feather like that, clamp it, and voila. There you have it. You have the feather. Okay. Now I'm gonna change the angle of my camera again. Okay. You see the feather is in my clamp now. So I take a large scissor. It's good to have a large, sharp scissor, and I cut off the stem. Try not to cut too much of the feather. And there you have it. Okay, I put this aside for a moment. I take on my dubbing wax, ski wax from Swix. You have large amount of dubbing wax here. This is only dubbing wax you need. You have the softer one and this one. This fits my need very good. Okay, but first of all, I'm gonna split the thread. I'm gonna show you how easy this is. You don't need any needle or anything, but you just unwind the thread. And it splits up in two. Very good. You don't need to flatten or anything. Just have to. There you have it. Okay. I'll split the thread in two. I take the dubbing wax. I wax this so the feather won't slip in the loop. And there you're gonna take the feather and put it inside the loop. Let's see if I can do that without any problems. Yes. Let go of the feather like that. Wind this little baby first and keep it up and spin your bobbin. Transfer into the loop. The force into the loop from the thread. Continue to do that until you get your all your fibers is sticking very good. Like that. Okay. Now you're gonna wind this around the ball. Round until you're satisfied with the amount of CDC. You don't want too much on this. This is more than enough. Okay. Take the rest of the fibers, take it out from the loop so much you can. And preen your fibers back like that. Make some wrappings on the end there by the hook eye, and take your whip finisher or your half hitch tool, whatever you like, and make a whip finish to finish this fly. There you have it. And secure the tread on my bobbin. This is an automatic Norwise bobbin, so it will unwind if I don't put on the cap. Then the tread stays on the bobbin. Okay. I take now this last finished step. I take the hook upside down and snip off the fiber underneath. And you can take out some long fibers. You can use your scissors, whatever. You can use your hands or scissors or whatever. So the main floatant on this fly is the ball. But also you have this CDC that helps it float, and it also indicates legs. So this is a very high floatant mayfly emerger. You can also use this pattern as a midge emerger on smaller sizes. This is a size 12. We have, for a midge emerger, I would have used size 16 and 18. With I replaced the synthetic quilt with some moose mane, black and white. I'm gonna make a pattern of those later on. So this is the high floatant mayfly emerger. That's all I had. Sorry about my English. Too much coffee today, I think. Well, as I said, you can reinforce it with first attach some UV resin on this. You can also adjust the amount of CDC around the ball. And this ball, it comes from a big bag from Vineyards. Like I showed you in the introduction. So that's all I had, and thank you all for watching my video. I'm now just around getting to have 1,000 subscribers. It's not much left now. So I'm looking forward to that. And thank you all for watching my video, and subscribe if you want. I've always tried to put on some new videos on the internet. So thank you all, and bye bye, and tight lights.